Now, to be delicately put, India is a price-sensitive market. We are obsessed when it comes to the value for money of automobiles. And guess what? Automakers have been taking notes. They have been cutting corners to make their products as appealing as possible for the Indian mass audience, which is one of the reasons why you might not find high-end premium features like a panoramic sunroof or cruise control in most of the cars sold in India. Hell, even basic features like automatic ORVMs and automatic air conditionings are reserved for the top-rung variant of cars. Now, this is not just in terms of features, as it creeps up into the mechanical department as well, and the prime example for it would be automatic transmission. Now, note this, past our shores, automatic transmissions are pretty much standard in most of the cars sold abroad. But we Indians love manuals. Yes, it gives you better fuel efficiency, yes, it is more fun to drive. But picture yourself in excruciating traffic, and that exact manual transmission is just another nail in your coffin, which is also being noted by all the automakers who have come up with new and innovative solutions to tackle the problem. Able to cater to a large variety of audience, from a cost-conscious buyer to an enthusiast. So since the market is loaded with so many options, we thought we'll give you a complete rundown on the types and how it functions. Hence, without further ado, let's get into it. Now, the torque converter automatic transmission is by far the most common one on the road today. It involves a complex torque converter that transmits the engine's rotation energy, while the gear shifts are being controlled by a vehicle's computer and accomplished by a set of planetary gear system and a series of clutches and brakes. Though the behind-the-scene action is quite complicated, all the driver has to do is select from the familiar PRNDL choices on the gear selector. The advantage is, of course, a simplified driving experience and a gentle learning curve. The trade-off for the driving simplicity, however, is the mechanical complexity, which makes the automatic more prone to failures and pricier to fix. Torque converter automatics are advantages of big torque at low revs, which is great for acceleration off the line and overtaking. Acceleration from the standing start is smooth, as are the gear changes. However, one traditional problem with the torque converter is that they are essentially inefficient, which usually means larger than usual fuel bills. A few cars that have the torque converter include the Ford EcoSport, the Mahindra Thar, Tata Safari, and Kia Seltos, among others. Continuously variable transmission, or CVT as you can say, offers a similar driving experience as the torque converter, but has a different set of mechanics altogether. For instance, it doesn't have any gear. It operates with belts and pulleys that offer an infinite range of ratios. The vehicle's computer adjusts the pulleys and offers the optimal ratio for the required driving conditions, which is one of the reasons of its primary advantage, fuel efficiency. Since they are not as complicated as the automatics, CVTs are less prone to failure and costly repairs, though not as much so as manuals. Their biggest drawback, however, may be subjective one, the driving experience. Since there are no gear shifts, just smooth and seamless acceleration, CVTs may leave a true driving enthusiast feeling like he or she is operating in a plant instead of driving a car. Cars that feature the CVT include the Hyundai Creta, Hyundai Verna, Honda Jazz, and Nissan Magnite.
The DCT, or the dual clutch transmission, is pretty much a hybrid between a fully automatic and a fully manual system. This kind of transmission gets the mechanical layout of a conventional system, but has a system of pneumatics and actuators that does the gear shifts. It gets two separate clutches for odd and even gears, which results in incredibly quick shifts. It can either be operated in fully automatic mode or with the paddle shifters on the steering wheel.
Semi-auto and DCT transmission offer cutting-edge performance with lightning-fast gear changes that a pure manual just can't match. Currently, these gearboxes are mainly found on race and high-end sports car and are therefore quite expensive. This disadvantage is magnified by their extreme complexity, which leads to more frequent and costly repairs. But you can find a DCT in India in cars including the Hyundai i20, Kia Sonet, and Volkswagen Tiguan Allspace.
Now, the automated manual transmission, aka the semi-automatic transmission, aka the clutchless manual transmission, everything points at the same thing. It's to essentially take the job of shifting gears and clutch action from the driver. It basically comes in two options, either a single clutch or a dual clutch.
AMT or automated manual transmission is mechanically similar to a manual transmission, except that the sensors and actuators perform the clutch work and shift gears. A car with an AMT does not have a clutch pedal. There's only the accelerator and the brake pedal. AMT also allows manual gear shifts when needed by pushing forward the gear lever for upshift and pulling it backwards for downshift. Cars like the Grand i10 Nios, Tata Tiago, Mahindra XUV 300, Hyundai Aura all have automated manual transmission.
Now the IMT or the intelligent manual transmission is pretty much the only one who whispers sacrilege in this list, and for good reasons indeed, because it's not completely automatic per se. You see, this kind of transmission has a conventional gear stick like a manual transmission, but no clutch. How? We'll tell you.
Hyundai's IMT is a hydraulically operated system. There are three main units to this system: a traditional gear shifter but with an intention sensor built in, a hydraulic actuator, and a transmission control unit. When you decide to change gears, the control unit is notified of this by the intention sensor. The control unit then uses the hydraulic actuator to create pressure. This pressure is used to control the clutch and pressure plate via a hydraulic mechanism, allowing the clutch to be engaged and disengaged without manual operation. Since Hyundai debuted the transmission on the Venue, it can also be found in cars including the Kia Sonet, Creta, and the Kia Seltos.